It has a timber floor. When children run up and down the foyer, it's something akin to World War III, commencing right in your own lounge room. So could we take care tonight to keep children either in their seats or on your lap, and I know they're going to enjoy the production tonight. On behalf of MUDBRICK Performing Arts Company, have a wonderful evening, and welcome to the Steddy Family Christmas Show.
Introduction to psychology. Memory, intelligence, personality. Oh, here it is. Psychological disorders, page 265. Passive aggressive. No. Obsessive compulsive. No. Delusions. Maybe. No. Stress disorders. Oh, no. There must be something wrong with him. No one would do this every year if there wasn't. Last year, the fire brigade. The year before that, electrocution. Always something goes wrong. Why would Dad do this? Why can't someone else in Mount Everon host the Christmas party? It's okay, Brooke. It's all right. We'll all be over soon. Okay. Guess we better get this show on the road.
You know, there's a reason he's always got that stupid grin on. comes Jan, says, she looks $1 million.
You think so?
Yep, kind of green and wrinkly.
Hey, come on.
Come on, yeah, hurry up and get things going, will you? What are you going to do this year?
Red, violets are blue. I call these flowers. I thought of you. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. On I will, O gorgeous one, but not until I press these lips of mine upon your lips.
Go away. Good night.
Oh, wow, well, Trev. Trev. What have we here?
This is John.
Yeah.
And Paul.
Oh, yeah.
And George.
Oh. I get it. And that's Ringo.
Ringo? No, that's Dave. Who ever heard of someone called Ringo?
giant pancake.
Well, man, it was so groovy. I remember that.
Well, that was last year, and that was an accident. There'll be no problems this year. I can guarantee that. I know, listen, guys, just come in a bit. Let's sort of try and make sure we all understand how this is supposed to be, okay? Firstly, I'm really appreciative of the fact that you've, you know, given me a talent for our Christmas party this evening. But my Christmas party, it's about peace and goodwill. Peace and goodwill. Now, I don't want to Bible bash you guys or anything, but after all, as the angel said on the night our Lord was born, behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. Now, that's what my Christmas party is all about. You know, I get everyone in the neighbourhood together and we sing the songs and we tell the good tidings, you know, God really loves us and good tidings to everyone. Oh, look, you know, we just try and get everyone together and let the atmosphere rub off on everyone. It's what the world really needs, don't you reckon? So here's what I'm after. Plenty of those sweet, soothing Christmas carols. Anything with a sort of, you know, peace and goodwill feel about it. Nothing too loud or rocky. Don't upset any of the neighbours that can't make it. And after all, it is the birthday of our Lord. So, peace and goodwill.
Yep. Hey man, there's no problems. We can really cut it. It's been a few years now, but yeah, we can play them all. Yeah, man. We're looking forward to tonight. Let's give them a chance to sort of blow the cobwebs out, you know what I mean?
Not too loud.
No way, man. Birthday galore and all that. Just give us a few minutes to practice and we can play anything, really. Be no problems.
Real? Are you play anything?
Yeah.
Well, actually, there's one song I've always wanted to sing myself, and I'm sure you'll know it. See if you can practice this one up for me. It goes like this. To dream the impossible dream, to find the unbeatable flaw.
I'm sorry, I've never heard that one before. Do you know that one, guys?
No, man.
Gee, I'm sorry, Bill. Don't know that one.
Oh, it's okay. No worries. Funny. No one ever seems to know that one. Never mind. Look, you guys get into your practice and then you can mingle when the guests arrive and the barbie's done. Thanks very much. I'll be inside if anyone's looking by.
Cool.
Great. Okay. Come
on. Oh, yes.
Hey, you've got girls. Oh, great.
What are you doing? Hey guys, how's it going?
Good to see you.
Ready,
Rick. be awful for Paula, not to mention Fred and Elizabeth. Oh, Christmas is such a sad time for broken families.
I feel real sick. I'll go in and change, help her. I'll do something. I'll go and see.
Don't say anything, Philip. Look, if you go in there, you will just probably go in and make a mess of it and change things. No, look, just leave her alone, I think, and let her settle down and enjoy the rest of the night with me. Okay?
The only reason he keeps his head above water is that wood floats.
I heard the Steddy's to come in.
An MD? Really?
Yes, mental inhibition!
remember last year, Troy impressed the neighbours by making a monster crepe Suzette and burn down the Christmas tree!
Somebody put methylated spirits in the maple syrup bottle.
What about the year before that? When little Bedford dog got electrocuted. Poor little Fluffy.
Well, that's just a case of tragic timing. I mean, I didn't know Fluffy was doing that to the Christmas tree when I was turning the lights on. It's not as if every year is a complete disaster, Jen.
Oh, don't give me that. Let's just cast our minds back to the year your brother Russell was here. And
all right,
we had
okay,
that...
I get the point. It's okay. Let's not mention Russell again. It's all in the past, okay? But trust me, Jan. Look, this year, nothing will go wrong. I promise.
Oh, do you really promise, Phil? No hidden little surprises this year?
Look, honestly, Jan, what do you think I am? Well, actually, I've got one incy-tinsy little surprise.
No.
But trust me, Jan, it'll be fine.
Oh, no, please.
Look, it'll be fine. Look, are you okay? They'll be here soon.
No, I'm not. I'm not up to all this. It's too much stress.
Stress? What stress? Jan, this is the season to be jolly. This is the season of peace and goodwill. Look, Jan, for one night, we become the hosts of happiness. We become the community cornerstone. As the angel said on the night Jesus was born, behold, I bring you good tidings.
Oh, Philip, for goodness sakes, just bring me the bread and let's get on with it.
Oh,
Grandma, you're a lifesaver. Thank
bread.
You. Just put it wherever you can find room.
Bread.
Thank you, dear. I'll have it. Thank you.
Oh, listen, Mum. Could you get Uncle George to come and have a look at that Christmas tree? I've been fiddling with it and I can't seem to get it to work. Must be one of the bulbs, I think.
Oh, God, there'll be people here any minute, Philip. Look, come on, get on with it.
I'm right, I'm right. It's okay.
Just on.
It'll be fine.
There.
There we go. Just there. That's it. You right? Good.
Oh, here comes Tony and Veronica.
Is it? Oh, hey!
Knock it off. I look terrible, don't I?
No, you don't look terrible. You look like someone who's about to host the best Christmas backyard party in Mount Evelyn.
That's just the trouble. Jim and Heather don't live in Mount Evelyn. They can't
come from Camberwell. I'll bet nobody in Camberwell would dress like this, not even to a barbecue. Oh, Phil, they'll be all dressed up and I just look so ordinary.
Well, I guess we are ordinary. And look, don't worry. Jim and Heather know it's only a barbecue. They wouldn't come dressed up to a barbecue, would they?
Heather would. And besides, Phil, I don't want to be ordinary. I want to be exotic. Just for once in my life, I would like to impress. Look at these jeans and this shirt. I'm not going to impress anybody in this. Oh, Jim and Heather, they have just come back from Fiji again. Imagine it, Phil, Fiji. Oh, their lives are so interesting and exotic. I mean, shopping trips to Paris and weekends on Hamilton Island, lunch at the Regent. Oh, everything about Heather oozes exotic. Even her name is exotic. With me, I'm just Jan Steddy. But she's Heather Paris. Imagine having a name like Paris.
Well, okay, it's a name. But I don't think they're very clever calling their children Buckingham and Crystal.
You are so middle class. Anyway, this year I've got something that will impress Jim and Heather.
What?
Voila! Pate, Phil.
Pate.
Yes.
Oh, Jim, I want those little cocktail thinkers that you dip in sauce and the little sausage rolls and the party pies and the little triangle sandwiches with the hundreds and thousands. Oh, that's real party food, Jim.
No, no, stop your tantrum. No, no party pies and sausage rolls this year. No, Jim and Heather deserve pate. Cultured people don't eat cocktail frankfurts dipped in tomato sauce. Cultured people eat cultured food. And this year we're going to impress Jim and Heather and serve them pate.
Yuck.
Stop.
Don't even like
it. Have you ever even tried it? Go on, taste it. You dip the biggie in. Lovely.
I know.
Go on. Go on.
Well, what's in it?
Ooh, yummy. Go on, taste it. Yeah, Grand Marnier. And herbs.
Mm.
Spices. And goose livers.
Why, goose liver? I don't think the middle class was ever intended to eat goose liver. Goose guts.
I don't think you've got any class to it, Steddy.
Look, I have had an absolute disaster. I broke a nail.
to get through Christmas like this. When can you see me, darling?
Okay, Alan. Bye now.
Bye, darling.
See ya.
You have got to get yourself a mobile phone. I mean, look, darling, they're just so handy, aren't they? And just so impressive.
I don't need a mobile phone, Jen. Phone on my desk works just fine.
Get them a drink, would you? There's a good boy. Now, for my special guest, something very, very special.
For us? Oh, Janice, that's lovely of you. You didn't have to, though.
Yes, yes. Not everyone appreciates the finer things. But just for you, goose liver pate with Grand Vania.
Look, Heather, it's pate.
Yes, pate.
Yes, it is pate. That's good, isn't it?
Oh, sort of.
Sort of.
Jim and Heather hates pate jam.
Oh, look, Jan, don't take it personally, my dear. We just eat pate at all those phony parties we have to go to. You know why we love coming here, Janice?
Why?
We get to eat real food and meet real people. You know what I'd really love right now?
Know what?
Yeah, those little saveloys. Dipped in tomato sauce and party pies and sausage rolls.
Oh, yes, and those cute little bread things with sprinkles all over them.
I would like Jim quite right, Heather. Look, Dan and I were just only saying before you came how a party isn't just a party without real party food. Right, Ken?
Right, Sal. Yes, darling, you're always right.
Yes, I
am. Excuse me, just a minute. I just remembered I have to talk to Grandma about something.
Ring.
Yes, raise up my nose.
I hear you. Just give me a report on that table on your side of the garden, thank you.
We've got a suspect in here, Jim. Could be salmon. No, make that guacamole.
Of course, it's plastic. The usual.
No savoys?
No.
Party pies?
No.
Sausage rolls?
No.
Okay, Buckingham. Call me if the situation improves.
I think I found it! It's a wicked little up like a Christmas tree!
Uncle George, it is a Christmas tree.
Well done, Uncle George. Let's have a moment. I'll turn the switch on. Here we go. Count three. One, two, three.
Hey, everyone, it's time for John Fun to do the carolling stuff on the television. Come on!
Hey, look, we've got a big TV screen. Come on inside, everyone. We'll watch John Fun.
Inviting us. You know, we always really enjoy yours and Phil's company. You're both just so lovely. You don't try to put on airs and graces, and you're just so real, the two of you.
Yeah,
Yeah, well, really. Well, I just hope we don't have our usual disasters again this year.
What's a burning Christmas tree between friends? The most exciting Christmas we've ever had.
And what about Fluffy?
Poor old Fluffy. But that's only two disasters.
Yeah, that's because you've only been able to come the last 2 years. I still haven't got over Russell.
Russell? Phil's brother Russell?
Yeah, unfortunately.
What's happened to him?
I don't know, Heather, and I don't care. I only know that he wrecked my little sister's life.
What? Oh, you've never told me about this before.
Ah, you were overseas at the time. I didn't want to talk about it. I never did cope very well with him, Harry.
But I remember Phil from years ago when Jim and Phil were doing their accounting exams together. But he was always a really decent guy, and I thought it was so romantic. Two brothers marrying two sisters.
Russell was a decent guy. That's just it. He was the best thing that happened to Margie, especially after our lousy childhood. He was a great athlete, too. He was playing league footy, really.
Yeah, that's where his trouble started. He started drinking. You know, having a few beers with the boys after training at the club. He was just doing really well when he did his Achilles tendon.
Oh.
Well, that was the end of his playing days. But unfortunately, it was just the start of his drinking days. He became a closet alcoholic. He held his job down, but at home he was always on the booze. Margie was just miserable. After an alcoholic father, she didn't need that.
What happened then?
Well, it just got progressively worse. Got to the stage where he was even hitting her. Dreadful. Anyway, 3 or 4 years ago, they were here at our Christmas party. We sent Russell off down to the shop to get some ice cream for the kids. He came back 3 hours later, blind drunk. Mm. Totally out of control. It was so humiliating. Margie tried to take him home and she got a split lip for her trouble.
No.
Phil tried to get him under control and Russell gave him a broken nose. The neighbours heard all the commotion and rang the police, of course. The kids saw it all. Oh, it was dreadful. So much for peace and goodwill.
That's just awful. How did you ever cope? What happened next?
Well, that was the end of the marriage, of course. We didn't see Russell again after that. Margie moved out of the area and never really got over it.
Don't think I will either.
Ah, look, enough of that. That was then, this is now. How have you been, Heather? Look, I know I carry on like a pork chop over your gorgeous clothes and your trips and everything. It's just, I mean, your life is just so interesting.
Interesting? Well, maybe.
Oh, come on, Heather, it is. I mean, it's exciting and romantic. Not like mine. I mean, mine's fine, but it's kind of steady. But your life, oh, wow, trips overseas, weekends on tropical islands, lunch in fancy hotels, parties with Tom.
Just stop. You've got the wrong idea. It's not what you think it is.
Sure, we travel and we spend and we travel some more, but so what? I don't even know who I am anymore. I don't know what's happening to me. And my kids. And my marriage. I hardly think I know Jim anymore. These are lovely. Where did you get these? Oh, Phil bought them for me. He's so sweet in his own funny way. He says, roses are red, violets are blue. I saw these flowers and thought of you.
I got a bunch of roses last week. A beautiful bunch of roses. Do you know they must have cost $200?
That's fantastic.
It was signed, All My Love, Jim.
That's lovely. He cares.
It was his secretary's handwriting. I phoned him to say thanks for the thought, but he didn't even know anything about it. And I found out later it was some new company's policy designed to preserve family wealth. I can't remember the last time Jim actually bought the flowers himself. Do you know, Jane, I have everything in the world that money can buy, but I'm just so lonely. I'm really lonely. Everyone in my life is so busy buying and selling things. I don't have any real friends except for you. No one who really knows me or cares about me. And all those exciting people I meet, well, they're just so phony. I know I can't share myself with them. We don't go to church anymore. I don't know what to believe anymore. And I don't even know if Jim loves me anymore. I'm scared, Jim. I am really scared, Hoover.
Don't you even know you felt like that? Have you told Jim how you feel?
You have got to talk to Jim about this. No.
There you are. Oh. I've been looking for you. Didn't hear my name being taken in vain, did I, ladies?
Look at the flowers that Phil bought for Jan.
Lovely.
Look, excuse me, you two. Let's go check those party pies for you, Jim.
Fine. What is it you need to tell me, Heather?
I'm lonely, Jim.
Oh, is that all? I can fix that.
You can?
Sure. I'll buy you a dog.
I don't think I need a dog, Jim. I've got you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, I don't know. What's happened to us? What's happened to the caring and the closeness? I don't feel close to you anymore. You've gone so often, and when you are around, all you're doing is planning your next big deal. Taking phone calls, scheming and dreaming. I wonder if you just ripped it. You know, all I've been doing is crying lately. I need you, Jim. I really need you. But I don't know how to find you anymore. I hate the way we're living.
Once again we sit in silence.
We sit in silence.
Baby, look what we've become.
Look what we've become.
Once again we sit in silence.
In silence.
Baby, look what we've become.
I do love you, but I think we need some help.
I know we need some help, and I do love you too. Come on, let's go and join you.
So boring. It's like Dad always says. Steady by name, steady by nature.
The only time it ever gets exciting around here is when something goes wrong. Last year, Jared Hill said he could see the fire from his place, and he lives in Montrose. Awesome! Anyway, I'm sorry this party's not a real rage.
Rage? For the past year while my parents have been breaking up, I don't think I've seen anything else but rage. I've seen all the raging I could handle for a lifetime. No, Mickey, I really like homey things. I like them a lot. You know what I like about your dad?
No, what?
He likes your mum.
Well,
you can see that, well, she gets a bit sensitive about some things and she does get a bit prickly, but... You can see the way that he looks at her, and the way that he talks to her. He just likes her the way she is. I feel really safe being near your dad, Mickey. He's got a lovely family.
You think so?
Don't you?
Yeah, I do.
You know, sometimes I feel like I would never be able to trust a man enough to marry them after seeing my mum and dad break up. And then I see your parents and I think, well, hey, it might be okay. And coming to church with you has really changed my life. If Jesus hadn't come into my life, I feel like I would have just ended up hating even my mum or dad for what they put me through. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Christmas is so hard for a broken family. How am I supposed to be together? But we're all so torn and apart. And you know what the worst thing is?
What?
I love them both. I love my dad. I know he's hurt my mum. And I love my mum. I love my dad too.
Former God has turned the wind, and now the children pray, rescue me. The whole world passes by, it won't look them in the eye. Who will hear their cries? Rescue me. Rescue me. Rescue me. A young girl sits and cries. Rescue me. Rescue me. Rescue me. We're empty.
Subject. Thought it was about time that I got some practical experience. So I started working as a voluntary worker with a counselling agency in Ringwood, and I'm going to do facilitator training with recovery groups at church. But you know, the more time I spend studying psychology, the more certain I feel about what I want to do with my future. There is such a need for good therapists, and I really love seeing people finally get a hold on what's been twisting their emotions or the behaviour and begin to work their way through to wholeness. What do you think, Crystal?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, sure, I think it's great.
Mm.
One day I would love to help people.
Yeah?
Do you think Red is really mean?
Huh?
Heather, I mean Mum, she thinks I'm a Red. And my deportment coach and my colour coordinator at school thinks I'm a Red.
Uh-huh.
But deep down in my heart,
yeah,
I really think I'm a mode.
Oh, right. Well, in that case, hey, do you mind, Crystal, can we just do, like, a short, quick little psychology experiment here?
Sure, okay. Great.
Great, okay. Now, I just want you to make yourself totally comfortable, all right? Great. Just let all the tension go from the mind. Oh, no, you have to uncross your legs. And your hands. And your mind. Right, okay. Now just let all the tension go from your mind. Okay? Just relax. And tell me the first word that comes into your mind as I say these words. Black.
White.
Sun.
Moon.
Toast.
Dad.
Car.
BMW.
Holidays.
Fiji.
Boy.
Dog.
Brother.
Bigger dog.
Father.
God.
Mother.
Dogma.
Auntie.
Me.
Lonely.
Me.
Red.
Fingernails! Oh, Father, before you have a look at this, do you really think Red is me?
Oh, Crystal. Look, I know I'm not a psychologist, at least not yet. And I know I'm no expert, but you've got big problems. Chapter 3, Miller and Goldenstein. Oh, I knew I'd seen it somewhere before. Transference and denial. Crystal, I have been watching you and listening to you all night. What's going on inside?
I know people think I'm an airhead, but I'm not as silly as I seem. I think a lot. And I have feelings, Brooke. Feelings I don't like at all.
Can you talk about them?
I don't know.
Do you want to talk about them?
Do you know what I'm getting for Christmas? A horse. A white arrow. You know how much they cost? Too much. You know what I really want for Christmas? To feel really close to my dad. Really close to my mum. Sort of feel like a real family. Then we've got these everything. A swimming pool, jacuzzi, sauna, gym room, tennis court. Wow! But Dad's always going somewhere. And Mum, she's always busy. And I feel like I'm supposed to be playing this game about how all my visits to the beautician are so really important.
Don't mess with me, kid. I used to be a school teacher.
Oh, 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 oh
Beg your pardon, man.
Alfonso, the singing renaissance is here. Have no fear. Cartridges around, please. Don't lose them, they cost money. Thank you very much, man. Keep your eyes on the word. A bit of concentration and you'll all enjoy this a whole lot. Thank you very much. Pass it, man. How do you do? Long deco, lady. Thank you. Nice to see you. Excuse me. Only way to enjoy Christmas, ladies and gentlemen, is to get involved. Lots of involved. And Alfonso is here to make your night complete. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Alfonso is here. Thank you. Now, with the words in your hands, ladies and gentlemen, as I said, I used to be a school teacher, so if I don't even concentrate, we could be here for a long time. I've got another appointment.
30 minutes.
Let's get into this now. Okay, are we ready? Red Santa sings for you lots of laughs. You can't know how good this is. Eyes on the paper. Really good stuff. Thank you very much. I want you to look at your words here. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Let me sing these first few lines for you, then I'll tell Tom to make your life complete. By the way, I've just put out my first album, Santa Sings for You. It will be available at the end of the program tonight. Cassette 25, CD 35. Are you ready, ladies and gentlemen? Red Santa sings for you. Thank you very much.
Russell.
There's like a bad guy. What's going on here, Mark? I don't see one.
The next morning when the police told me that I'd broken Phil's nose, I'm sorry, mate. I really am sorry. Look, I just thought that no one would ever want to talk to me again. And I knew I'd lost Marg that night, and I just hated myself for that. My drinking just got worse and worse, and so look, I just took off and I went away, and I never planned to come back. Well, that's it, Jen. Something's happened.
What happened?
Look, Phil, look. A couple of months ago, I ran into an old school friend of ours. You remember Macca?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, Macca's become a Christian.
Mad Macca? You mean Macca Phillips?
Yeah, Mad Macca Phillips. Look, I couldn't believe it either, but look, we sat down and we talked some stuff through, and look, I started to really see things differently, and Phil, I got down on my knees and I prayed.
And
something happened inside.
What?
Look, I'm not sure really how to explain it all, and I'm not even sure how it's all going to end up, but all I know is that I asked Jesus to be my Lord and to forgive me for the mistakes I've made and to give me a new start, and since then things have been different for me.
Come off it, Russell! That is the last refuge of a con man, religion. What do you expect us all to do? Sing the Hallelujah chorus? You boy here after all you've done. You expect us just to forgive and forget?
Look, I understand, Jane. I really do understand it. Look, I only came here tonight because I knew inside that I couldn't let one more day go by without at least saying I'm sorry. And I guess it just sounds so pathetic to say I'm sorry, but Dan, I don't know what else to say. Look, I'm sorry it hasn't worked out so well tonight, but look, I'm going to see Mark tomorrow. I don't know how that's going to work out either. But it's Christmas Day tomorrow, and look, I don't want to muck up another Christmas party. Look, I'll just go.
Don't go, Russell! Don't go!
Thanks for that. All the best, mate.
Let mercy reign. We ask for you.
You know, the more I study psychology, the more aware I become of something. Psychology doesn't resolve everything. Psychology can't fix everything. And it certainly can't explain everything. Because, you know, in all of my psychology books, there is not one single chapter on love. So what is love? Sometimes I think it must be some kind of mental illness. Because, I mean, it makes people do things that don't entirely make sense. Like Mum and Dad forgiving Uncle Russell. He could so easily mess up again and hurt everyone. Like God sending his son Jesus into this strange and broken world. I mean, imagine that. God coming down from heaven to live as a man and to die for us. To open the door of heaven so that the relationship between man and God could be restored. I mean, what a risk. And what's in it for him? Love is really amazing. It makes people do things that don't always make sense. I don't know if I'll ever understand, psychologically speaking, but I'm just so glad that Christmas means love. You know, love is the only thing really worth living for. Jesus, you make life worth living. Can I say to you this Christmas, Jesus, you are the one. You're the one that's made this family what it is. I mean, we don't blame you for the bad bits, but for the good bits, the patience, the love, the caring, the hope that we have, both now and forevermore, we owe it all to your love. Jesus, you make life worth living. You've taught us how to forgive. You've taught us how valuable we are to God. You've taught us how to value one another. We owe it all to your love. Jesus, happy birthday. We all love you.
You are the one, the goal of my life.
go so well either. So why not? It's been lovely to have you all here tonight. All because he is the one. All over the world, people are putting up trees, buying presents, preparing for a day of happiness we call Christmas Day. May God give you a great Christmas in 1993. May God help you to know and to love and to rejoice in the one who really is the one. I'd like the whole cast to come out on stage, if you would. I'd like you to show them your appreciation for this evening. Come on out. Yeah, you guys can come out too. Come on, cast. That's the way. Come on out, cast. That's the way. They did a wonderful job. They're so dedicated. And before you all go home tonight, I'd like the boys and girls to come up and get something out of good old Santa's bag. Whoa, 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 whoa. We're going to sing one more song for you tonight, a happy song. And if you'd like to stand up as we sing it and get into it yourself, just behave. Who's going to lead us away? Thanks, John. Away you go.
Christmas time, we love to have fun.